And welcome back to Game Time presented by Lithia All-America. And we'll pick it back up in the 2A ranks where the Alpine Bucks were rolling into the area round. They sported a 9-1 record after their bye round last week. And they were looking for a regional round berth as they took on Abernathy out in Big Spring. Out to Memorial Stadium for this contest. And the Alpine Bucks defense gets the ball thanks to an interception here by Aaron Ontiveros. Nice play. Bucks march their way right into the red zone. And Vince Molinar runs down the sidelines. Puts the Bucks up 7-0. Looking good so far, Chase. Abernathy would turn the ball over on downs on their next drive, and Alpine's Evan Moore would waste no time capitalizing. He hits
Oscar
Trevino in the middle, 75-yard. He gone. Bucks would miss the extra point, though. They still have a 13-0 lead. And Slopes, though, finally get their offensive gear with quarterback Garrett Royale with cheese, if you're a Pulp Fiction fan. Pitches the ball to Tyler Cooper. He waits and finds Clayton Lewis, who has his defender beat, and he catches the ball to put Abernathy on the board. Alpine still on top 13-7, but Abernathy comes all the way back from behind. They take this game tonight, ending Alpine season 38-26.
Let's go way out to Clyde, where Munster and McCamey. Sorry.
Jump
the gun there, sorry, Trevor.
Before we do that, let's go to some 2A scores. Chase, some games tomorrow. Colorado City taking on Sanford Fritsch. That should be a good game. Wolves are favored in that game. That one's out in Plainview. And let's go right along in the 2A score. Now we're going to get to your game.
Now we're way off in Clyde. Munster and McCamey meeting in the area round playoff game. Badger defense putting some pressure on Munster. Hunter Clement flushed from the pocket. Goes deep to Clint Sidwell. Finally, look at that. Just kind of like lost and blown coverage right there. Walks into the end zone. Hornets led it 11-0 in the first quarter. Munster gets the ball right back, and they march right down the field. Mason Binder caps off that drive. 18-zip Munster at that point. Badgers, they're looking for anything to go their way. Jordan Zarat tracked down in the backfield. Ball pops loose, and Munster recovers. And they take advantage, Trevor. Here's Steven Flush breaks into the secondary for a huge gain. Look at that video. Breaks it.
I don't know if that's the player of the video.
You can't tell. But nonetheless, big game there for Flush. And then Trevor Hess finishes the drive to give Munster a 25-0 lead at the halfway point. McCamey manages a few points in the second half, but that's it. They fall to Munster. The final score in that one, 39-12.
Moving to more 1A action, Albany, taking on Iran out in Colorado City, Wolf Stadium. First quarter, 7-0. Albany, Zeph Hernandez hits, look at this name, Creed Kane in stride. And if you got an awesome name like that, you know you're going to score an awesome touchdown. Long touchdown pass. We're tied at 7 apiece. Second quarter, same score. The Lions on Iran's 1 yard line. Samuel Raymond gets the carry, punches his way in for 6. It's 14-7. Albany later in the second, extending their lead. Jake Bumgarner on the keeper here, rolling out to his right, finds his way into the end zone, breaking some tackles. 21-7 at that point. Albany would send Ira Ann home tonight with the 49-25 win.
Moving right along, Monday taking on Wink. This game was out at Colorado City as well. First quarter, Monday already up 8-0. And check this out. Roderick Taylor gets the handoff, and he's gone. Down the far sideline. That one's a 50-yard run. Cuts back all the way for the touchdown. They go for two and convert. 16-0 Moguls. I really like that mascot, Trevor. Now in the second quarter, same score. Riley Richardson. Look at this for Wink. A perfect pass to Corey Funderburg for a touchdown. Great catch there. They go for two and convert as well. Cuts that deficit to just 8 points. But second quarter now, Monday on top, 23-8 already. And Taylor, again, another huge run. Goes 60 yards for the touchdown. 30-8 Moguls at that point.
We're having mic malfunctions.
The Moguls get the ball right back right here. Tyrone Dawkins gets the ball. 15 yards, pretty much untouched for the touchdown. Monday in front by 29. Now let's take a look at the score. Monday, they send Wink home. Final score in that one, 63-34.
Good season, though, for Coach Hernster and Wink. Moving to the six-man ranks tonight, only local six-man team in action this evening was Balmoray taking on Lorraine down in Rankin. Bears trailing 6-0 in the first, so what do? They hand it off to Casey Dutchover. Breaks the tackle. He's gone long way for the touchdown. Extra point good. Bears lead 8-6, but back comes Lorraine. Timothy Garza takes the pitch, then hits Ricky Cantu in stride, and he beats the defender to the end zone. Touchdown, Lorraine, 14-8. They lead later in the half. Bears look like they're going to retake the lead, but Isaiah Mendoza at the goal line. Fumble, Ruski, not the place you want to cop it up. That would lead to this. Timothy Garza out of the backfield, breaks a couple of tackles, He is gone up the sideline for the score. However, fear not, Valverde fans. The Bears mounted a double-digit comeback in the fourth quarter tonight, and they went a close one tonight. Final there, 44-40.
Let's take a look at the scoreboard, Trevor. Some six-man scores, a game taking place tomorrow. Grand Falls Royalty undefeated. They're just mowing down the competition. First in the regular season, and then in the playoffs as well. They'll be taking on Robert Lee, that game out in Big Spring. And then also another game tomorrow, Petersburg taking on Grady. That kicks off at 6 p.m. Moving right along here, some more scores. Borden County at Turkey Valley, taking on Turkey Valley, another 6 p.m. kickoff. And Rankin versus Ira, 7:30 kickoff. That's in Big Spring, Trevor. And I'll have highlights of that game for you tomorrow night right here on News West 9 weekends. And in the Taps rank, Midland Christian, they are well on their way trying to defend that state title. They defeated Dallas Parish Episcopal 28-16, that final score. And we're halfway through our final game time of the season.
That's right, but we still have plenty more to come, including your Medical Center Hospital scoreboard and a final tribute to the 2012 high school football season. That's all coming up after this 2-minute timeout.